Hi, my name is DBS and you are watching Shinerweb YouTube channel. In this video, we will learn how to load data on scroll. So let us see live demo first and after that we will see how to configure this demo in your PC or in your project. So let us see live demo first. So here you can see I predefined some data load. When I scroll at that time, some another data will load. Again I scroll, then it will load more data. So this demo will work in mobile also or in a web browser also. So you must have to see how to configure this code into your website or into your project. Let us see step by step. So here you can see in step 1 you need to create one simple table. Like here you can see I provide one create table script. So you must have to copy paste this code and create this table into your website or into your go to your phpMyAdmin and create this table. I already created that table here, calendar event master. So you have to create this table and also you need to insert some sample data or some dummy data. So you have to copy paste this code and execute this query and insert some data. You have to copy and you have to execute 10 to 20 times because when you are run this demo at that time you need some more data, then and then you will get data on scroll. If you are inserting only 5 records then it will not load more data. So you have to insert some more data. Here you can see, so you have to execute this 10 to 20 times. Okay, this insert script you have to execute 10 to 20 times. So in your table you will get 100 or 200 records. And after that you have to create one simple file like index.php. So here you can see I create one file like index.php. I open that file. So here you can see. Now let us see step by step what code you need to write or what code you need to do here. So here you can see, and also here you can see, first you need to include some libraries. First I have included some library, like first I included jQuery min.js because we will write some JavaScript code and some AJAX call. So that's why we need to include this jQuery min.js, right? And after that you need to include bootstrap.min.js and bootstrap min.css for designing purpose. And here you can see I write some custom CSS code which is used to show our loader. Like when I load, at that time one loader will display. Here you can see this loading GIF will display. So here you can see for that loading GIF you need to position in a middle or something like that. So for that you have to include this some custom CSS, right? So you must have to write some custom CSS. Now in step 4 you need to write some HTML code, right, where we will display our dynamic data. So here you can see, here we create one table and there we will display our event name, start date, end date and all that. So here you can see we create one simple table and inside there and inside we will create 4 columns: event, event name, start date, end date. And inside this we create one ID in a T body where we will display our dynamic data. When we will scroll at that time we will put our dynamic data inside this T body. So here you can see this is our dynamic data which is load while we are scrolling. So whenever I scroll at that time our dynamic data will display inside this T body. So here you can see we created one T body tag and inside we pass one ID is equal to dynamic data, right? And sometime your data will not load on scroll at that time. So for safer size we create one button also like load more. So sometime if you are scrolling or if scrolling functionality is not work. At that time we custom created one button, and when any user will click on load more button, at that time your data will display or data will load on this load more button. Now once you create your table, and after that you need to create one AJAX call, right, to get data from the database. When you need to get data from the database, so for that you have to write one AJAX call. So here you can see we create one function like display data. So you must have to write script tag, and inside that script tag you have to write display data function, and inside this function you need to get data from the database. So here you can see we write one AJAX call, and inside that AJAX call we call one file like displayData.php, and from there we will get data from the database, right? So you must have to copy this code, and also I said that code here, so you have to write this code. Now once you create your AJAX call, you have to write some JavaScript code or some code which is call on scroll. So here you can see once your AJAX call will complete, here we write some JavaScript code. This is the most important code which is call on scroll. So here we write some logic of whenever you scroll at end, at that time our function will call like display data, which is already we have created here. This display data function we have created here, but when this function will trigger, so our scroll bar will go to end, at that time this display data function will call. So here you can see whenever I scroll at bottom, let us inspect first so you will get better idea. Here network, so here you can see when I go to down, at that time this AJAX function will call. So here you can see this display data php my function will call. Here you can see again I scroll down, here just I clear here, again I scroll down, when I go to bottom, at that time this display data function will call. So this logic we have write here. So this is the most important code here, so you must have to write this code, and inside that code you have to write or you have to call this display data function, right? So you must have to write this function inside this code, then your data will coming on scroll, right? So here you can see now, so you must have to write this code. Now you have to create one database file. Why we need to create one database connection file? Because we need to communicate with database, or we need to get data from the database. That's why we created this file. Here you can see I have created database connection.php file, and inside that file you have to write this database connection and some credential here, and after that finally you need to create one file like display_data.php, right? You must have to write this, or you must have to create this file data display_data.php, and inside that file you have to connect your database, and after that you have to write some logic to get the data from the database. So here you can see you have to create one file like displayData.php, display_data.php, and inside this file you have to write this code here. I also explained this code. So here you can see now what is row count. So whenever I load data from the database, at that time I store some data . So here you can see, suppose I refresh that date first. So here you can see whenever I refresh at a very first time, this function will call automatically and get data from the database. Here you can see I refresh and it will get data from the database, and row count will return 25. Here you can see at the very first time it will, here you can see it will return first 25 records, right? And that 25 records will return into AJAX response. Here you can see that 25 record will return in a AJAX response, and that AJAX response will display inside this dynamic data or append in dynamic data. It means are in that dynamic data will set inside this T body. So at the very first time we will set first 25 records. Now again when I scroll, at that time this function will call, right? And it will get 25 more records. So 25 plus 25, it means 50. So here we initialize that row count, so it will return more 25 records, and our row count is 50. So this is the logic. First we get first 25 records, and after that we require more 25 record. So for that we initialize that 25 record, but we have passed that offset here like 50. So you must have to write this select query and pass your row count with plus 25. So this is the logic, right? Again I scroll, at the time my row count will be 75. Let us see. So here you can see, row count will 75. So it will return more 25 records. So this is a simple logic to add 25 record, and we need to identify what is our row count. So this is how you can display your, or you can show your next 25 records. So you can also see in Instagram or in Facebook, whenever you scroll, you will get more posts on your website. So here same like that, whenever I scroll, it will return 25 more records, right? Again I scroll, it will return more 25 records. So this is how this scroll bar will work. This is a simple PHP code. You have to write that PHP code, right? So this is how this scroll bar or data load on your scroll. So you must have to configure this code into your website, or if you have any query while setting this code, or while set up this code into your website or into your project, please write down your comments in comment section. Or if you have any query or any question, please write your comments in comment section. And also I have shared this whole or entire source code, so you can download that source code, and also you can see our live demo by using this live demo button, right? You can also download our code from here. So thanks for watching.